3, 2, 1.
Welcome to Tiger Belly. My name is Bobby Lee, and I'm with Khalyla and Gilbert and Pink Dick George. And man, I want to say I'm very full of gratitude and love in my heart. Man, I just want to be, I'm appreciative of my life, man. Like, I was just in San Jose playing at the Improv there, and a lot of Tiger Belly fans came out, and a lot of people said George has a pink dick. Probably about 80 people. I'm not even fucking
kidding. Really?
Yeah, I swear to God. In line, people would just whisper, George has a pink dick. And it really made me feel good.
Our server, when we first got there Friday night, the guy who works at the Improv, who serves the food, he comes in with a drinks, like some fried shrimp, and he was like, George has a pink dick.
Yeah,
and we're like,
whoa,
who shit.
It's great. And I just wanted to say thank you, George, for, you know, I met you at Maker, and I've always found you as a really nice person. And I can tell that you really work hard and you're into things, and I really appreciate it. Gilbert, I just want to say that you're just a fucking ball of fresh energy, dude.
Whoa,
yeah,
man.
Dude, fresh energy. I'm not dumb, fucker.
All right, dog. All right, dog.
You're full of fresh energy, dude, and a nimble spirit, dude, like you bend.
Okay,
hold on. Your soul. I just want to say also is that when I look at your face, it brightens my day, bro. Like, you have a really good face.
Yeah, thanks, man.
And your intentions are good and pure, man, and your foundation is strong, bro.
My foundation?
Yeah.
Shit.
What about me?
Okay, well, we have to
judge. No. Khalyla already knows. Now look at me.
Let me say this. When I walk in, I'm like, my day kind of sucks. I see that yellow hat. I'm like, is that Bobby?
Yeah, it's nothing to do with my.
I'm not there yet. Then I see your face. It usually does this. Here's the camera. Okay, if the camera's me, this is Bobby. Hey, what's up, bro? And I just go, oh, I get so warm inside. I really do.
That's it?
I get warm.
You didn't, I don't like your adjectives for Bobby. You could have done a better job.
No, I guess not.
Warm?
I feel like you prepared a fucking paragraph for me. I feel bad now.
I know. I called you a nimble spirit.
You had said I had a great foundation?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Where I build a house on. But you know what?
Can I just say you're a good
now
guy?
Now I just realized
what?
That house is built on sand now, and it's not a good foundation. And you fuck you.
I'm not good with words.
I know, man.
I'm sorry.
Wasn't good. George, thanks for being here, man. Go fuck yourself. Now, let me say something. And of course, I have the beautiful and lovely and charismatic Khalyla, my girlfriend. My blessings are deep with her, man. You know what I mean?
Let's hold hands.
I don't
want
to hold hands right now.
Come on. Like lovers, babe.
Our blessings are deep.
Babe, like lovers.
And,
come on. Babe,
what I want to say
don't
is
leave
is
me
that,
hanging, babe.
What I want to say is that. What I want to say is that this weekend, not only were my shows very good at the San Jose Improv, thank you, San Jose, but also we were able to see probably one of the best nights of UFC I've ever seen in my fucking life.
Crazy night.
Misha Tate won, and she was losing the whole fight, I thought.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I thought she was losing the whole fight, clearly. The second round was hers, probably.
Second round, yeah.
But all the other rounds were all Holly, and at the last minute, she puts Holly in a rear naked chokehold, and it was fucking amazing.
That's the beauty about Misha Tate. She's, in several of her fights, she'll come from behind, and she'll come from winning, from losing a few couple rounds, and she's a finisher. She's a tough bitch, man. She's an ox. I mean, you saw her on top of Holly. Holly couldn't shake her off often.
That was crazy.
And then the fight after that, which was almost life-altering. Conor McGregor gets choked out, rear naked choke by Nick Diaz. And
Nate Diaz.
Nathan.
They're brothers.
I know, but Nick is 185.
I know.
They're the same. They're Mexican.
Can I just say something? Exactly.
Yeah.
Well, that's
from
what
the
I
209.
Say. You can't fuck with Mexican spirit.
Wow.
You can't fuck with that Stockton spirit. Those boys
are it's
Mexican. Hardy.
But Mexican.
It's Mexican because I'll tell you why. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
How many Canadians sneak over to the United States over the border?
I'm not sure.
Not a lot,
yeah.
How many Mexicans? A lot.
Everyone.
Everyone.
Every
of
single
them.
One.
They all
want
to come here and they do it.
Also,
you know why? Because of heart, resilience, right? And they're a tough group of people. And fuck, you don't fuck with Mexicans, man. You know what I mean? And Nick Diaz
but
was
also
getting
Canada has more liberties and they have universal health care. So why would they want to hop over as much as the Mexicans?
Because they have a lot of creepy white people up there.
That's true.
You know what I mean? They have serial killers up
like
there.
Like Georgie? Georgie, you're not creepy.
You know,
you're not creepy.
I mean, I know Ed Gein is from Wisconsin, but dude, you know what I mean? I love Canada. Canada's the best.
I want to talk more about this Connor thing. So we were watching it at the Improv, and it's a pity we didn't get a video of our reactions. I mean, I look at this right here. I don't know if you can see it, but that is rug burn because I literally did it.
She blew everyone in the room. I mean,
wait. So
Connor gets tapped out and she's just start pulling out dick instead of sucking. I'm like,
so what are you doing?
Baby, what are you doing?
I was like, suck crying. I was blowing and tears were going down. Yeah, I had given up on
life. No, she did a slide on her knees.
Because I was in disbelief. I mean, not so much like shock or disbelief that Nate couldn't pull it off. Because I was telling Bobby and I was telling everyone, if this goes past the second round, it could get interesting. I just didn't know it would happen that quickly and that soon. So I did a fucking knee slide on carpet, and I Human, the manager of the club, was standing right there, and I literally grabbed like hit this part of his suit. Yeah. And I got on my knees and I was like, why? Yeah. I couldn't believe it.
Did you cry?
Didn't cry. I love Nate. I honestly respect Nate. I love that he brings his fan base, and I think that he's underrated, underpaid, one of the most appreciated fighters in the UFC, and you know, I'm glad that he's finally getting his payday, because that motherfucker has been paying his dues for.
I literally ran into a different room and I fucking threw a table.
Like, actually, it wasn't a different room. It was the same room. You flip a chair and a table.
No, in the other room. Oh. I ran into the other room where there was no one there.
You went to an empty room.
An empty room, an office, and I pulled a table. I flipped a table, and nobody watched me do it. I just did it because it was just so stunning to me.
I want to know, because Gilbert is the ultimate McGregor fan. I mean, you are.
I don't hate Nate Diaz, but Connor.
Connor is your boy.
He's my boy.
He is. So what was it like? What did you feel in your heart?
I don't know. I would need it to be like replayed again.
Okay, so, let me do a rear naked.
Oh, so like Bobby's
naked
Bobby's
Bobby
Nate
real quick.
Diaz.
No, Bobby's, yeah, I'm Nate, and this is Connor, and
you don't have to do a rear naked.
I'm not going to do a real one on
he
you.
If he can't visualize what it was like seeing it, then he's a fucking retard.
Let me just do a quick one.
What, you just want to put me in a real nigga show? That's fine. But
he's like, well, just so you guys know, this was kind of a bit, but all right. Okay. I'm at the bar. I'm at Big Wang's.
I do some ground and pound. Ground and pound.
I'm like, oh fuck, Connor, get out, Connor.
Hold on, Bobby.
Okay. Do what Connor does, Bobby. Connor. Connor! I didn't cry, but shit, my heart dropped. My heart did drop.
No.
Now, we did all that for that.
Just, yeah,
just
to
FYI.
Know.
FYI?
Yeah, yeah.
She wanted to choke you.
We did all that for that.
Okay.
And can I say something? I want to say that I am 100% now a Conor McGregor fan.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know who
I listen. Listen for a second. Fuck. Mm-hmm. Okay. Didn't like him before. I was being sold on him a little bit through the years. I mean, throughout the year. But he was so humble. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
And he took it such a, like a man, mm-hmm. right? He's very analytical about it. You know about why he lost. Mm-hmm. But he gave props to Nate Diaz. Mm-hmm. And what Jose Aldo?
Who's Jose?
Jose Aldo Instagrammed it or Twittered.
Tweeted
the pussy
was so disrespectful
that he was
I now am on Conor McGregor's side for life.
But it was a little bit sus to me because the tweet was in perfect English. So I mean, I'm
I feel
sure
like he had a marketing person.
It was
a
marketing person who did that. They want the fight. UFC. They want the million-dollar fight. Every guy wants it. He's gonna stir the pot as much as he can to get that UFC 200 fight. Yeah. Is it the 200?
And people 200. Listening, probably half of you people don't even care about the UFC. I apologize for, you know what I mean, but it was such a dramatic,
very dramatic,
you know what I mean, moment, you know, in UFC history that I thought that it was something that we needed to share.
And,
okay.
And here's why McGregor to me is, I think John Jones is one of the most talented fighters I have ever seen. But I remember starting to kind of, my feelings for John Jones started to fade. Because I remember years ago when he was supposed to fight Dan Henderson. And maybe like 2 weeks prior, Dan Henderson pulled out from injury. Mm-hmm. And so Chael Sonnen stepped in and he was like, look, I'll fly in tonight. I'll fight him tonight. And John Jones was like, nah. I'm not going to defend my title against a guy who on short notice with a new guy. And that twice in the last 9 months, Conor McGregor not only defended on short notice, but he went 2 weight classes up.
Yeah.
I mean, you can dislike the guy for everything, for you know, being arrogant, for being, some people think he's a little like braggadocious, but that motherfucker has done so much. And and people throw in the whole race thing. Like they say, oh, you know, because he's a white man and they've really, this organization has pushed him because he's a white man. But I honestly think that there might be some truth behind that, but I honestly think there is no better person or ambassador for the sport that can speak like Connor. And Ireland's like an oppressed nation, you know?
Yeah.
So I don't think that he quite applies as like the typical really white man.
I don't even know if that.
What?
I don't know if that, I mean, that does, what does that mean?
No, because some people are like, well, what about, okay, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
They're like, well, how come the UFC, given that Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz have been around forever since they were like 17 years old, how come they've only ever gotten paid $40,000 per fight, even though they do have a huge fan base?
No, I'm talking about the oppression thing about the Ireland. What does that mean?
Oh, what do you mean?
What's the history?
Bobby,
what does that have anything to do with it?
I'm taking the words out of your mouth.
Well, I never said that.
Oh, God. What?
When did I say that?
Oh, God.
Oh, God, what?
This is where I'm going to expose you in 2 seconds.
Expose. Uh-oh. Expose Uh-oh. Away. Expose Uh-oh. Away. I have no idea what you mean by that.
Okay. Yeah, you want to be exposed?
Yeah, I'll expose me.
You want to be exposed?
Yeah, I love big exposure.
Okay.
I hate being indoors. I want to be exposed.
Okay. Oftentimes in this podcast,
uh-oh,
I will take what you've said, okay, and make it my own,
uh-huh,
because it's a little bit too, well, inflammatory.
Being a thief, but anyway.
No, it's a little bit too inflammatory for,
oh,
you to say.
Oh, shit, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
I
know.
Okay. Okay. Oh, see? You want, ooh, me to expose you or not?
Well, don't expose what I think you're going to expose. Expose the part that, when in terms of the Ireland thing, expose that.
Oh, selective exposing, yeah.
Well, you can't expose shit that, like, I said to her on the side that's, like, completely, like, private.
No, not, yeah, private. You know, it's not that private. I could expose you right now.
With who?
Oh,
you know.
I already know, too.
D?
Mm-hmm.
No. What does that have anything to do with the other thing I just said, bitch? One has nothing to do with the other. I can expose you, too, bitch.
Expose me.
You want to expose each other?
Let's expose each other. Come on.
Exposure with Bobby and Khalyla.
I'm not exposing nothing, okay? So anyway.
What I'm saying is everything that I'm saying right now is from a conversation that you and I have had over the weekend about the fight.
Okay.
In terms of you know.
I never said anything about the Ireland being
oppressed.
That's not
true.
But.
That's not true. Are you serious?
Mm-hmm. With the smile is so deceiving.
Strange.
Jesus,
you're
strange,
man.
You're strange. Just
you're
making up
strange
shit.
Strange man.
Because they were oppressed. Okay.
No, I'm just saying they've had a hard history.
And that's what makes them a champion.
No, that's not what I'm saying at all. Okay. Wow, if you could just attach some ears to the side of your face, that would be really nice.
Ooh. What are you getting all like aggressive for? I was just
fighting.
Smile,
it.
Khalyla. Khalyla,
smile.
Smile.
Get through it.
Smile for the camera.
Yeah, Khalyla's under
it.
The weather
what,
a little bit.
One more thing about that press conference. Did you guys see how he grabbed Holly Holm's shoulder?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. That was sweet.
That was, so
that was
sweet.
Endearing.
Damn.
But can I just say about Holly Holm?
Yeah.
Come on.
What do you mean?
Come on. Let's be real. And if I was just, if I ran into her, the only thing I would say to her is, come on.
Bob, is that Bobby Lee from Matt TV?
Yeah. I'll say, come on. Because it's seriously, you can't.
Stop it.
No, fuck, no.
Uh-oh. Here
you're the champion, all mm-hmm. right? And you're winning the fight. And there's a minute left, right? And there's a little bit of a pocket where Miesha Tate ran in. She swarmed in for the takedown.
A weak takedown,
she
too.
Didn't even have... She kind of snuck around the back.
What do you call that?
And Holly could have stood up. I just felt like she could have stood up, but she didn't. And all that other stuff was moot and too late. And you lost. And you may never get the belt back. So I'm just saying, come on.
Come on, Holly.
Yeah. You fucked up.
But you're a great athlete.
Yeah, I don't think that Connor fucked up. I think Connor miscalculated that he was fighting a Mexican zombie that has no feelings in his face. Because he hit him 1,000 times with
crazy,
his left
right?
hand.
That was a crazy
and
left.
And there was moments in there where Connor in his head said, fuck, I usually hit guys with these punches. Like Jose Aldo once, mm-hmm. right? And he knocked down.
13 seconds.
But this fucking Mexican zombie
spirit.
Just kept going. No, it's not spirit. It's just deadened. Nerves
and
in his
I
face
think also the advantage that Nate Diaz has is that with Connor and all his other opponents, Connor can employ psychological warfare onto them. He can get in their heads. He can, you know, get them to feel emotional. That's just not something you can do with any of the Diaz brothers. They're masters of not giving a fuck. They're masters of deflecting any type of psychological warfare.
They're dum-dums, though. Let's be real.
They're not dum-dums.
I don't give a fuck.
They're like Manny Pacquiao. It's simpleton.
You know what I mean? Just fucked it.
I think that they're eccentric.
That's eccentric?
Yeah, I think that they've had, you know...
I feel like we're eccentric.
They're No. I think that there is... That's a perfect word for him. They're often sometimes like, you know...
They're smart then. You think they're smart?
I don't... I can't say that they're not. I think that people have different type of intelligence. Maybe they're not great speakers. They're not great orators. They're not great, you know, in terms of maybe like, you know,
what
really
is
explaining
this?
How
the
they
money
feel.
Channel?
But he does have some good one-liners.
Channel.
What did he
That's
say?
That's what he said, yeah.
He said Connor was playing touch butt in the park.
Yeah. That was touch funny. Butt with that goofy ponytail guy, man. Fuck you.
With Ito Portal, the movement.
Code. Yeah. Touch butt. That's funny.
No, I like the brothers. I think that they're, you know, a great example of some just the hardworking dudes from Stockton. Fun,
right?
Let's
not talk about fucking, I mean, people are bored if they don't know about the UFC, and I feel bad, kind of guilty about it, you know?
Okay. Yeah.
But can I say something magical that happened on the way? We drove to San Jose, mm-hmm. and we stopped at a gas station, okay? And I got some Red Bull, you know, I got some nuts. You know, I love getting nuts over there.
Yeah.
Like not, you know.
Yeah.
Like getting like packaged nuts.
Yeah.
We were in
Santanella. I was smoking a cigarette off the side, and we're in Santanella.
Santanella is like
Santanella,
but fucking nowhere. There's
nowhere.
Just gas stations and
like Bakersfield
farms
or worse.
Bakersfield is a beautiful place. Shut the fuck up.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. It's a beautiful place, and thank you for the money. 2 weeks ago, that was an amazing payday. But I was smoking, and all of a sudden I see one cat, a little cat, and he was scared, mm-hmm. a little black one. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And he was like, meow, meow. And he kind of ran away.
Four in the morning.
I go, fuck, there's a cat, right?
Yeah.
I love cats, you know that. And then all of a sudden you looked out in the field, and like it's like they just started coming out of this brush. There was like these, I know it's not wheat, but they look like wheat.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? It's not wheat.
I don't think they were growing anything. It was like basically flatland.
It's wheat.
And weeds.
Okay.
It looked like wheat.
Weeds.
Okay, there's something growing. Yeah,
something
there's
growing.
A fucking
no. The argument of wheat or no
shrubbery.
Wheat.
Shrubbery. That's a better word.
Shrubbery.
Yeah.
Shrubbery. And there was a bunch of them that came out of there. It was a whole beautiful land of cats.
It was just this
field.
Big prairie of just kittens and cats.
It was
like,
and
how many roughly? Like
well, I saw about 20 maybe in
damn.
The beginning.
But in like a small area, and they were just running around free. So we wanted to go back there and capture.
Yeah. I mean, they weren't even feral, really. They were.
They were,
you
know, feral.
I mean? Well, I mean, they said meow to me. They didn't go, you know what I mean?
Oh, they spoke to you?
What?
They spoke to you?
Well, they would go meow like that. That's hi. You know what I mean? Yeah. Nah, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
They didn't do a Nate Diaz, you know what I mean? And then they went meow like Connor, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I want to go back there. And my opener, Billy Bonnell, and I one day we're going to make money.
Yeah.
And we're going to open up a cat sanctuary.
I think that's our dream come true. Remember when the lottery, that big lottery draw a few weeks ago, where that person, where like the jackpot was like $1 billion mm-hmm. or some shit like that. Bobby and I were, the night before, because we bought a few tickets, we were like, what are we going to do with this money? And all we could think about and all we could conjure up as a plan was to just build a cat sanctuary.
Yeah.
To just buy a shit ton of land and just... You know, spay and neuter cats and then keep them if they don't have any homes.
I mean, we're not going to grab everyone. There's an interview process. Only the good ones and the cute ones.
What are these? So what are some of the things you have to qualify?
Well, the
only
color.
Pretty cats then?
Oh, the color.
Yeah.
What colors are exempted?
What?
What color? Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
I have a cat. I have a couple cats. I wanted to know, I have a black cat. I have a white cat. And I have a yellow cat.
What does a black cat look like?
Like a Donald Glover.
Oh, it's a Donald Glover cat.
Yeah, it has.
There's
same...
no white spots or nothing.
No, it's a Donald Glover cat.
Yeah, nah.
What do you mean nah? Sir, this is a cat. You said it's a cat sanctuary.
I said nah.
Okay, what about my white cat?
Yes.
What about my yellow cat?
Yes.
But my black cat?
Nah.
Oh, okay. I guess I'll go to Petco.
Go to Petco.
Interesting. Okay.
Because of bad luck. It has nothing to do with the race. There's no race in terms of cats.
I didn't even bring up race.
I'm just telling you that right now. The color of it has nothing to do with race. I'm just going to say that. Okay. It has to do with, like, you know, superstitions.
Okay.
Right? So if a black cat, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? If there was a horde of black cats, they wouldn't come into my sanctuary.
What are
all black cats?
Well, if there's spots of white, then they're like Obama. So then
so,
I'm like,
so race is involved.
Race has nothing to do with it.
Oh, okay.
But to me, they're like, you know, they're not as bad luck because there's some white in it. You know.
Okay.
What, I mean?
What about? Oh my God. What about like a one-eyed white cat or nope. a three-legged yellow cat?
Nope.
But it looks
so
at you.
No.
I don't give a fuck.
No injured.
Three legs.
Meow.
Nope. Well, it wouldn't. The second sound wouldn't come out.
If it okay,
a second sound would not come out.
A three-legged cat. Yeah. It actually says Bobby, and it's a sign from God. A cat actually says your name, but it has three legs.
Well, then yeah, of course.
There we go.
But that would never happen, Gilbert. Because if it said Bobby, then I'm gonna be like, oh shit, I'm gonna make a lot of money because now I have a circus freak show.
Okay, true.
Right, and I would charge money, $50 a head, and it can talk. You know what I mean? And I'll be killing it. All right, but that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
All right. So let's say you're a three-legged cat.
Yeah.
And you're a guy.
Yeah.
Sell it to me.
Hey, I have a three-legged cat.
Cool. Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Does it say circus on my fucking sanctuary?
Hey, man, it's my cat.
I'm asking you a question. Do you
know? No, it's my cat.
Well, then go.
Your wife has been very quiet this whole time.
What? She's a jungle Asian.
I'm also part of the circus.
The jungle Asian. She's in the circus.
Is that the lady with three boobs?
Yeah.
No. Yeah. No, only. You know what I mean? Cats that aren't fully black and that have all four legs and eyes and stuff. And I'm telling you right now, it has nothing to do with race, and that's fucking ridiculous.
Or disabilities.
It has to do with disabilities.
Oh, it has to do with disabilities, though.
Yeah, because let me ask you a question.
Okay.
All right, let's say that I have a cat that's fully, like, healthy.
Yeah.
Four legs, right? Mm-hmm. Eyes, all of it, right? And I have a cat with no eyes and two legs. Mm-hmm. Be ripped apart,
but it's a sanctuary.
There
you go.
What do you mean?
It's a sanctuary.
So there's like ponds, and there's like
everything.
Ambient music playing. What the fuck are you talking about?
You're gonna kill off the Beethoven of cats.
Oh wow, I didn't think of it that way.
You're gonna kill off like basically like the Amadeus of cats. Wait, not Amadeus, just the Beethoven. You're gonna kill off the Beethoven of cats.
What? Because Beethoven was deaf. Is that what you're trying to fucking relate
yes.
to?
Yes, he was disabled.
He slowly got deaf through time. Okay.
I'm sorry, but he was still deaf. It was just like, okay, so if the
forget
cat
it. Fuck the sanctuary. No sanctuary.
Closed.
It's not called a sanctuary. It's my house. I want to build a ranch, right? No sanctuary. I'm going to have a bunch of cats in it, and they're my cats. Well, and I get to choose.
Then yeah, those rules.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's it.
Speaking of superstitions, so you said no black cats because of superstition. Like yeah. What are actual superstitions you really believe in?
Me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Oh, I believe in a lot.
Tell me, name a few.
A hat on the bed.
What on the bed?
Yeah, it's a year of bad luck.
Oh, really?
There's a hat on the bed?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, you ever see the movie Drugstore Cowboy with Matt Dillon?
Oh, yes, yes. Yeah, I remember that. Yes.
So they say hat on the bed, year of bad luck.
Yeah.
Oh, that makes a lot of sense. No wonder I've been miserable.
I don't believe it. I believe in that. I believe in walking underneath the
ladder.
Ladder.
Uh-huh.
Walking underneath the ladder is just
bad luck.
Opening
an umbrella indoors.
Oh, that one too.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, another one that came true in the Philippines.
Touching a Persian.
that wasn't it.
That's one. Touching a Persian.
Babe. Remember. Not the Persian.
Yeah.
I don't want to touch a Persian.
Yeah, don't ever touch a Persian.
I've kissed a girl.
That's 10 years. Oh, then that's
Persian
30
girls
years
are
of fucking...
very pretty.
And very
yeah,
pretty.
Yeah, but bad luck for 30 years.
Oh, fuck. Want to kiss a pretty girl?
Yeah.
Bad luck for 30
years. I remember in the Philippines, we right before I had my whole like a medical emergency where my heart basically
died.
Exploded
yeah.
like a ticking time bomb. We went out to a Chinese restaurant and we had a whole fish, like a whole steamed fish. And I told Bobby, it's like, you know, it's bad luck when you eat like the top part of the fish and then you flip it to eat the other side. You're supposed to eat the fish up, eat the meat up top, peel the bone off, and then eat the under part. So you just remove. You're not supposed to flip the fish.
But see, the thing is that.
And then literally, we did it anyways. They're like, fuck it, fuck the superstition. And then 5 hours later, I was in an emergency room, and then I was in intensive care for
Whoa.
5 days. So that's one that I hang on to. So I'll never flip a fucking fish again. I know that's stupid, but
interesting.
Well, you know, can I just say this though? In some countries, they just completely take the bones out before they serve it to you.
Why? What?
What do you mean, why? So I don't have to fucking flip nothing over.
Everything has to be filleted for you?
Yes.
Ooh, that is some fucking
really
first
do that?
World bullshit.
Oh,
thing.
Can I ask you this, Khalyla?
Yes.
If I ordered a steak and they brought half a torso of a cow out.
Which right? they did yesterday when you ordered
right?
half
with
a
the
fucking
tail,
torso
right?
of a cow.
You know what I mean? I'm going to be like, this is bullshit. I just want the side.
Have you not seen a Filipino lechon? They'll put the whole fucking pig on a table with its face and everything. The whole thing.
And they're going to flip it over.
They're not going to flip the pig over.
Are there any Korean superstitions that your parents kind of followed?
Well, touch a Persian was
one. Is that? No, shut up, man. Are you being serious? Okay.
Bobby, don't touch a Persian. No. No. Really? I don't mean that. I mean, they weren't superstitions. My dad would say stuff like, don't watch TV too close.
You'll go blind.
No, no, grandpa will die. Oh. Like, he'll make it up. He'll make shit up.
I like the comedic reversal.
Yeah, he would make shit up.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Or grandpa will die.
Yeah.
That's intense.
I said, he's already dead. You did it.
Too much.
Too much TV.
Or like when you say, when you do, you know, you cross your eyes, then they say if the wind blows, it's gonna stay like that permanently.
Yeah, stuck like that.
Or if you're laying on the floor and then someone walks over you, your growth is gonna get stunted and you'll never grow past that height that you are.
Yeah, that's
a very like Filipino
thing.
That's
the one my dad does, yeah.
Yeah.
Speaking of growing though, that one astronaut, he
grew two inches.
He fucking grew 2 inches, George.
So Scott Kelly, who spent 340 days in space because of microgravity up there, he came back and they measured him and he was 2 inches taller.
You know this is going to happen, that the Chinese mm-hmm. are going to go up there and have a program where, you know, because you know what they do now, if they want to get taller, mm-hmm. Some Chinese people, they have that surgery where they cut the bone, right? Then they leave a gap so the bone fills in. It's the most painful surgery.
Is that
surgery.
How it works?
Is that really
it takes
how?
Years Oof. To fill in. But these young people do it so they can get taller.
Oh, my God.
But you
God.
Know that they're going to go to space now.
Oh, shit.
That's how much they want to get tall, is they'll cut the bone, leave a gap, and then it fills in.
Yeah, but part of the reason why Asian people weren't tall to begin with was because of, like, poor nutrition. But if you see the Koreans now, like, who actually live in Seoul, or, like, in the more, you know, in bigger cities in Asia, they're tall.
Yeah, I know.
Like Korean girls, I mean, even when I was in Korea, they were like 5'7", 5'8".
Yeah.
Who actually lived in the city. I'm not sure about the rest. I mean, Filipinos are generally still short.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But my sister's 6 feet tall, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But
she's mixed with French, so. Anyway, so this Scott Kelly went up there for a year, and then everyone's celebrating the fact that he was in a spacecraft for a year, and I'm like, who gives a fuck?
Why? That's the most amazing thing. This guy gave a year of his life to science.
I don't give a fuck. Let me say this, okay? Then Khalyla asked me, can you do it? I could do that all day, dog.
What, chill in space?
Yeah, for a year.
For starters, Scott Kelly, I follow him on Instagram and I follow him on Twitter. He takes the most like amazing photographs. I could do that too, dude. He actually is a legit astronaut. This isn't his first time in space.
I'm just saying that, can Bobby Lee survive in space for a year?
No.
Why?
I don't even think you can handle the G-force of any like upwards or downward travel. I think you would like throw up and pass out.
That's not true.
Yes. I think we should put you.
No, that's not true.
Yes.
You know why? Because I was at a carnival once, right? And they had this thing, you know that thing where it spins, like you're in a room and it spins in a circle and everyone gets stuck to a wall, right?
Really?
No, yeah. You get stuck to the wall with the G-force. And there was a malfunction, I swear to God, on this thing where they couldn't turn it off. So everybody was on this thing, I swear to God, for 40 minutes. And you're only supposed to be on it for two, three minutes.
40 minutes?
Yeah, 40 minutes.
40.
People were freaking out.
An hour?
Yeah. Yeah, they shut the thing down, right? This was in Del Mar. They shut it down, right?
Oh, my God.
And I was stuck to the side for 40 minutes. And people were vomiting, right? And it was coming into their face, right? And I took a nap. Shit, no business.
Frick, is that Asian guy just sleeping right now?
Yeah.
What the fuck?
It was no big deal. I just, like this, I don't give a fuck. 40 minutes, I wasn't panicking, and I could have done another 9 hours. Fuck G-Force.
There you go. Bobby's not affected.
And everyone got out, and there was an ambulance. People were like coming on gurneys. People thought people were gonna die, right? I walked out, I wasn't even dizzy. I walked out. I had a cigarette. I said, later. I left. Give a fuck, bro. Nate Diaz style, bro.
209, Mexican 209. Spirit.
Yeah, so fuck the G-Force. Give me another one.
Here's what I think we should propose. What else won't
I survive?
I don't think that you can...
I can float.
Yeah, I know you can float. But I mean, like, Scott Kelly did other things in the International Space Station. He's a legit astronaut.
I'll wipe down the mirror.
That's not.
Hey, if there's an astronaut, hey Bob, there's like a little space debris on the wind mirror. I'll wipe it down.
Okay, I think that we should propose this to NASA. Then I think that you should give a year of your life to science.
Yeah.
And you should try and beat Scott Kelly's record of 340
days. I'll see how much money do we get? 5 years? Give me $5 million for 5 years. I'll do it
for 5 years.
I can do it for 5 years. Ugh. Well, number one, will I get space food up there?
Yes, you will.
Number one, that's fine.
I wonder if your dick grows.
Bobby will test that.
Because
I'll test that a full year.
I'll for sure test
1 year out of the 5, 1 year will be dedicated just for that.
Dick testing.
For dick growth?
Yeah, yeah. I'll stretch it out. You know what I mean? You know what I mean? I'll masturbate. You know what I mean? What it's in space.
How do you think
I'll nut and then I'll try to swallow the cum and then floating in there.
Come on.
I'll do all that. You know what I mean? I'm just saying that I could do it for a year. Now, if they're like, hey, can you fix that engine or jet propulsion? Yeah. I would be like, I don't know anything about that. So that's how Scott Kelly has an advantage over me. But in terms of just like living up there, it's not a big deal. Is all I'm saying. Anyone can do that. George can do it. You can do it. Everyone can do it.
I would have a panic attack in the first 2 days. To be confined like that, to not have just... I would freak the fuck out. Even thinking about it, my anxiety is through the roof.
Just unless there's no cameras so I can do things. You know what I mean?
I wonder if you can smoke up there.
Ooh.
Or you can actually just chew then. Right? No, he would have to just have probably nicotine patch or like...
I would chew? Dip. Right? Why can't you smoke up there?
Because... I mean, unless
can you
want...
Can you vape up there? I'm sure you can vape.
Can you vape?
Yeah, yeah. I don't know too much about that.
I wonder what sex is like when you're when you're floating like that.
It's like being on a, I don't know what it would be like.
It would just be really slow. It would just.
Yeah, slow style. Whoa.
Yeah, whoa. You would really have to have controlled movements.
Wow, chicka, wow. NASA, motherfuckers, pornhub.com.
Speaking of sex, Khalyla, I'm going to just, there's nowhere to go around this. Khalyla texted me one day.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
Can I bring it up? Can I bring it up?
I don't know what you're
saying. I know, but just give me permission to bring it up.
You can do whatever you want. It's America.
It's America, bro.
Oh, Bobby, sweetie, yes. Something happened last week.
So Khalyla texted me.
Something happened. I'm sorry, everyone.
Not freaking Bobby. So she was, is that the week she had fever brain?
When I was having a fever last week.
She texts me and goes, Gilbert, I had a weird dream. And I went, what? And I'm going to just say the thing, and then you can explain it in more detail.
Okay.
She said, I had a dream that George ate my butt.
I wasn't going to tell you. I was only supposed to be for Gilbert. I'm so sorry, George. I didn't plan to dream that
he's
you would...
He's freaking out. George is freaking out.
Can I just tell you what the dream was?
Death stare over here. I get the death stare.
Can I tell you what the dream was? How it happened?
Tell Bobby.
Because I had to unload it onto someone. I had to like... Stop. And I couldn't tell Bobby because then it'd be weird.
Stop. You have a dream.
I'm so sorry, babe.
That George eats your butt. And you text Gilbert, and I don't know anything fucking about it.
Well, because you weren't going to wake up for another 5 hours, and I had to tell someone.
But I eventually did wake up, bitch. And you could have said, hey, I had this dream.
Yeah, but
George
you were.
Ate my butt.
But the last week, you get upset when I dream about Conor McGregor or other people.
That's
couldn't...
fine, but fucking George?
That's what I said. I'm so sorry, George.
Fucking George.
I'm so sorry, George.
I mean.
This is what happened.
Tell the detail of what happened.
Okay, so apparently we were in some like Disney World resort type hotel.
Jesus. What the fucking fuck? Christ.
Of course George would do weird shit like that.
Yeah, yeah.
No, but we were all there.
I wasn't. I wasn't there.
So you guys were
all right,
were
so
there.
Walk it through.
Okay. Yeah,
walk
it. It was really strange and I'm really sorry about this, George, but what you did was I was putting my socks on like this on the floor. Like I was on the floor putting my socks on, and then you kind of come from the side and you tip my body over like this, and you just started like munching from sideways. So I was like this, and then he stops, and then I said I was like, hey George, and I was like, whoa, I feel really bad about this. And he goes, you shouldn't, Khalyla, because guess what, I can guarantee you that Bobby cheats on you on the road. He's like, I can prove to you that Bobby has been cheating on you. fuck? And George? But then he continued eating my butt, and I was like, what? I'm so sorry.
Number one, okay. You're fucking down on your knees, and you're changing your sock.
Yeah.
You tip over.
I'm not done.
Just listen, okay? You tip over, mm-hmm. right? George comes in to eat your butthole, okay?
He tips me over.
Exactly. Okay. Don't interrupt again, okay?
Sorry.
Which means that he tranquilized you with a gun, because when you tip somebody, right? You know what I mean? There's struggle. There's no struggle there. So, bitch, George fucking tranquilized you, ate your butthole, right? And you're like on your side now going, what? You know what I mean? George, what the fuck is going on?
She
right?
can't move.
Yeah.
She can't move, right? And then George Pink Dick goes, and it says a lie. He deceives me.
He tried to lie to win.
Right? And he lies to win, right? Fuck you, dude. George, look at me right now. Fuck you, man.
So uncomfortable.
George, why do you do that?
Yeah, because I'm going to say right now, dude. Everything's interconnected, and there's thoughts going on, right? And there's some sort of visualization going on, like The Secret or some shit, right? And it's seeped into our fucking dreams, so go fuck yourself. You're still working for this show, right? But if you ever do that shit again, I swear to fucking God, you're out.
If you tip her over.
Don't ever tip her, and don't eat her butthole.
A tranquilizer.
Okay? Jesus Christ.
And so, Disneyland?
At Disneyland.
It's a Disney World resort. Bro? It was a resort hotel.
In Florida, Disneyland and Disney World.
Fucking you're Bob at Disney hates World. World. He hates Florida.
I hate Disney World. Oh. Yeah. Oh, wow. Oh,
was that crazy?
So let me ask you this. You okay. flew, George, you flew Khalyla. George, look at me right now. You flew my girlfriend to Disney World. Why?
Well, I flew all of us, obviously.
I wasn't in the dream, fucker.
I wasn't there either, dog.
Yeah.
I think
so
we
you
were
flew
all there.
Khalyla. All right, that's your own thing. That's fine.
It's interesting.
But I'm just saying, dude, you know, your thoughts are very powerful. Don't do that again.
And she, okay? And she did say George didn't have his normal voice.
Yeah, you were very commanding. And, you know, I think, George, you're like one of the sweetest people I know. You were commanding and you were like.
Stop for a second. Okay.
Sorry.
Stop.
I'm beginning to think that George has nothing to do with it. He didn't visualize it. He's an innocent bystander, and he's sitting here going, "Wow, I'm embarrassed." This shit is subconscious within you, bitch.
No, it's not.
Yeah. There's some sort of fucking.
Oh, there probably is with the whole butt eating thing.
Yeah. No, and George. So you want George? Deep down inside, you want George to eat your fucking butthole, bitch.
I don't think that's how dreams work.
That's how it's subconscious, dude.
It's like Inception.
It's like Inception shit.
Because
yeah.
I always dream. Like, I remember having dreams about, like, my fat swim coach and I, like, hooking up. And I thought
it was,
like... Yeah,
and
it's
disgusting, and you thought that in your subconscious. And
guess what? It happened.
No, yeah. I think that it's more of, like, it's just a... You know, an amalgamation of random subconscious thoughts. I think it pulls from different things. It's like I have feelings about butt eating,
no.
And then the person I saw before was George.
Stop. Okay, I'm going to tell you this right now. Okay, throughout the history of my life, right, and in the future, mm-hmm. I will never have a dream where George eats my butt. Do you know why? Do you know why?
I don't know, Bobby.
Because it's not even the realm of my thinking, right? There's nowhere in my brain at all where this fuckface is going to even go anywhere near my fucking butt.
Does he tip you at any point?
No, he doesn't tip me nothing, because that's not in my brain, right? This bitch right here, that shit's floating around in her fucking brain. And in her dream, she's like grabbing things and pasting it all together. Like, she has an editing system in her brain where she takes different tipping and George, but and all that
Disneyland,
stuff.
Disneyland.
And puts it all in one dream, like a mishmash of ideas.
Oh.
And bitch, that's you.
That's on you, man.
That's on you.
Please forgive me.
Get the fuck out of here.
I know that's now fucking what gross. I do. Please forgive me.
So that happened. You know what I mean? And you know what's so funny? I would have never known if you didn't bring it up.
You're what?
No. Don't pound me, bitch. Because I'll tell you right.
I'm looking right out.
From now on, this is what happens.
Okay.
Okay. She texts you any dream, right? With this fucking guy in it.
Forward right away.
Right? You tell me right away.
Okay.
For my, you know, private, personally.
Hang on 1 second. Gilbert, are you loyal to him or me?
Gilbert, look at me right now, dude. Gilbert, look at me right now.
Gilbert,
look at us right now, all right?
Can I just say, can we just get back on George eating out your girlfriend's butt at Disneyland?
No. Look at this. Well, okay, I'm not offended, bro.
I'm not offended
either. Who are you loyal to, Khalyla or me? And you can't say both.
You can't make me say that.
Yeah.
Be real.
And I'm not going to be offended.
In your heart of hearts, who are you, loyal to?
I need a scenario.
No, there's no scenario.
This is the scenario.
I'm not, no offense, and I'm not going to take it out on
you. I'm not choosing one. I decline.
How dare you? I'm offended by that then.
Yeah, she's offended
because
by that.
Oh, you're offended? Are you offended by it?
No.
Oh, then I'll choose you because you're not offended.
Oh, for you, fuck you.
And then you know what? That's the truth right there.
But no, Auntie, don't be mad at me.
Auntie, that's the truth. And you know that. Let's move on, okay?
The rich man always wins.
I know. And also, can I just say this? All right, before we move on, look at me right now, dude. Okay? Look at me right now, George. All right? I swear to fucking God, when I said in the beginning of the podcast was true. I really do. I love you, man. You're a good guy. Mm-hmm. You fucking work hard, okay? And the first day I met you at Maker, because I used to be signed with Maker Studios, and that's when I met you. And I looked at this guy and I went, wow, this guy, I can tell, right? Mm-hmm. He's 100% pure.
Yeah.
Right? If you ever eat Khalyla's butthole at Disney World, you don't even know what I will do to you, okay? I will devastate you, okay? So that's out there. You too.
Yeah.
Nobody eat her butthole at Disneyland.
That's great.
Or Disney World, yeah. Okay? That's it. You can tip her.
Just constantly tip her.
Yeah, you can tip her over. That's fine, okay? Wow.
You feel better, Khalyla? That's out there now?
No, not in the slightest.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not in the slightest.
Anyway, let's move on. I mean, that was a fucking, what a revelation.
Wow, right?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Gilbert. I want to recommend a movie I saw also this weekend, mm-hmm. also, just before I forget, is The Hateful Eight. Really good movie.
Is it?
You see it?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I really liked it. It was so weird.
3 hours long, right?
Yeah, but really set in one room. It's set in a cabin. You know, it's really weird. You know what I mean? And it's like, yeah, Jennifer Jason Leigh is fucking amazing.
Yeah, she's
fucking amazing.
I fell asleep, but
yeah, she fell asleep. Yeah,
no, not because I didn't think it was good, just because it was 5 a.m.
You know, I was always wondering when I was watching Jennifer Jason Leigh, like, what did she do in the last 20 years when we didn't see her? Because there was a gap where you didn't really see her that much,
yeah.
Right? What does one do during that gap? I guess I'm going through that gap now, so. You just do other things.
You guys see each other in the room.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I just answered my own question.
It's crazy though how she comes back and then she gets nominated for an Oscar.
Yeah,
that's just a testament to how talented she is, because she was really good in that movie, or at least the first hour that I saw.
Yeah, I love Tarantino movies. There's really not been one, except for Jackie Brown was okay.
Mm-hmm.
That was a little
I like
weird.
Jackie Brown.
Yeah, but other than that, I loved every single one of them. You know. And we haven't seen The Revenant yet. Oh, congratulations to Leo too on the Academy. We haven't talked about that Academy Award.
Yeah, we have last week.
Not the winners though, just the Chris Rock thing.
Yeah. The winner, Leo. And congratulations to Dat Fan, because I'm going to say right now, I'm going to say about that, he is working on Scorpion, the television program.
As a what?
He's a guest star on it.
Whoa.
Yeah. And yeah, he's congratulations to you, my friend. You worked really hard. You sell out everywhere in the country. And we've seen your acting skills on your Instagram. And I'm just saying right now.
Are we his official PR team?
I want to be.
I think that
if
you
should. If
he
paid me money, I would, you know what I mean? I would totally do it. And I want to say you're killing it. And my hat's off to you, dude. You're killing it. Congratulations.
Also, he dropped from 172 pounds to 153.
He's been working out. He's been studying. He's been working hard.
He's been doing yoga,
and I've been studying him.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. And I've been watching. And I got nothing going on. I'm shooting Love next week, so that'd be fun.
Season 2 already?
Yeah.
Did you get all the scripts?
We did the third episode, Table Read. And I'm doing that, you know, and I'm excited about it because it's a whole episode revolved around my character.
Ooh.
So I'm very excited about that. This is the only one I'm in. Second season, but
this is the only episode?
I think so. I mean, they haven't finished the scripts, but like I just make an assumption that it is. And I'm pretty excited about it.
Dude, episode 3.
Because a lot of Khalyla in it.
You're in it?
Well, no, but they, you know, they asked me about my relationship and my, you know, my...
The storyline is a little bit, I think it's probably inspired by our rapport with one another.
Yeah. So that's cool.
Did they cast the girl yet?
They did. I'm going to meet her tomorrow, I think.
Is it tomorrow?
Or Wednesday.
I don't know who the actress is.
I don't know who it is either. I try to get any of those. I try to get Holly.
Don't give it away.
Oh, yeah.
If you say that, then it gives away stuff. You're not supposed to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Ronda Rousey.
So I was reading this article about, have you guys ever heard of burial pods?
Nope.
So basically this company, now instead of coffins, they put you in this biodegradable like capsule, and they put the dead human body in like a fetal position in a biodegradable capsule, and they, which can be then planted underground, and then a tree can, or it's like you can plant like a seed and then have a tree grow on top of that capsule. So like now they're called burial pods. They're really cool looking. So now, like,
nope.
And so the family can take care of the trees, water the trees, and watch it grow.
I don't give, nope.
Isn't that kind of, like, keep poetic? Going.
It's fucking stupid.
How is that stupid?
I'm going to do what Walton the Disney did.
What did he
that
do?
That makes, freeze my body, and in 1,000 years from now, when you figure out what was wrong with me, unfreeze me and fix my shit. I don't want to be a tree, bitch.
No, you're not the tree, but you're nourishing a tree to grow.
I don't care.
Like your body, right?
Your body. That's decomposing is allowing.
Let me ask
for
you
the
this. Can I ask you this
tree.
Question? Am I dead?
You're dead as fuck.
Well, then that's it. That's it. I don't give a fuck. You know what? How about this?
You thought you were alive.
Well, you think Walt Disney is dead? Is not dead as fuck?
No, he's not. He's frozen.
So before, okay, this is my question. So before his organs actually started to decompose, they were able to suspend his the decomposition, cryogenize or freeze it in a state that 100 years from now could possibly be brought back to life?
Yep.
Oh, I want that then. Yeah, fuck the burial pod.
Yeah, yeah. He's, you know what I mean? He, as soon as he did, they froze him, right? And then when they have the technology to do it,
yeah,
it could be from 100 years from now, whatever.
Yeah.
He'll be walking around and it's like he's going to create nude characters. And it'll be great. Because the ones he has right now is stale, right? They're Mickey stale. Mouse, all that shit.
Yeah. Ooh.
He gets some new shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But like, that's what I would do. This fucking pod bullshit. Who gives a fuck?
I think it's, I mean, you so can do beautiful. That to my... And you can have like, instead of like flat cemeteries with gravestones, you can just have a forest.
Or what about this? Why don't you chop my body into little pieces, mm-hmm. right? And then bake it in as a dumpling.
Ooh, right? Yeah. Keep going. I like
and
this concept.
Little, yeah, like a dumpling, right? And then you go to a koi fish pond and just throw it in there and see if they eat it.
Interesting.
Same concept. Fucking shit. Who gives a fuck?
Koi fish will eat anything. I want to be mounted on a wall, just like this.
Oh, yeah, like half body.
As a prize.
Oh, no, you know what I want? Yeah, that's great.
What do you want?
Half your body.
Half of, like, a manananggalba. Like a,
whoa.
Like a manananggal is like a half body with wings. You know, it's like in Filipino mythology, that's like what we're afraid of, what we're like made to be afraid of when we're children. Mm-hmm. And it flies. It just has half a body and has wings. I want to be mounted like a manananggal on someone's wall when I die.
I'll never be able to say that in my life. Manananggal.
Say it, Cloud.
Manananggal.
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 Oh, you did it well. Yeah, perfect.
Manananggal.
Shut up. You guys did it well.
You know what I want?
What?
This is what I'm going to... I swear to God, I want this.
Oh, God.
Okay? As soon as I die, I want them to put me in a gigantic jar of formaldehyde. But before they put me in there, though, you got to put me in a tuxedo. All right? I need to be in a tuxedo and a little top hat that doesn't... You know what I mean? That just stays on.
Yeah.
Right? And just somehow make my face smile, right?
Botox.
And I'm floating in this like formaldehyde jar, right?
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna have all these buttons, like outside of the fucking jar. There's a panel with a bunch of buttons, right? And one of them will probably say Gilbert.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're still alive, you can press it, and I go, "Hey, Gilbo."
Oh, yeah.
Like so I have
personalized messages,
for
friends and family.
People, you know what I mean? Yeah, Pink Dick George. Right, if you're still alive, and you'll get a giggle because you can still see me. I'm smiling, right? Yeah. And you know what I mean. What do you think?
What happens when you click Khalyla? Here, Khalyla.
Yeah. Don't eat George. Don't eat her butt. Something like that. George, don't eat her butt. Something like that. Yeah. No butt. Eat George. Something. But I mean, I want to have hundreds of, you know what I mean.
This is so thought out.
Yeah, because I literally have thought about it.
Holy shit.
Yeah, where I I'm gonna have all that, and then I wouldn't decompose, right, in formaldehyde.
Formaldehyde, no. But then use formaldehyde.
Now, how do I do it?
Formaldehyde's like...
Or maybe you can stuff me, like, what do you call
I
it?
Hate taxidermy. The smell.
Taxidermy, yeah.
Taxidermy me, and then you can do more with my body. Like, I can do like a hop in the sky, you know, and click my heels
click your
together.
Heels,
yeah.
Like this, mid, you know what I mean? So float me up, and then have the buttons.
Float him up.
That'd be cool.
Float me up.
Yeah, float me up. Yeah.
What
yeah.
are buttons? Oh, to press.
Like a little button. Computerized button. Or you could do a flat screen thing, maybe.
Like, yeah, flat screen.
We'll just have like an iPad there.
Like, you know, the new Coke, like the new Coke machines where you can just push.
Yeah, things. You could just kind of press and you have a glossary. Mm-hmm. But what if, like, you thought I was your friend and then you're not on the iPad?
Yeah.
You're not one of the pre-recorded. Yeah, that's about
you. Like, you get excited, yeah, you so come.
It's like this. It's
and
like,
you go under G and there's like 1,000 Gs.
Yeah.
But there's no Gilbert.
Real scenario.
Oh, I can't wait to do this. Okay, where's that? Where's Bobby didn't put my name?
I would put that.
You would? Okay, yeah. Ready?
Doop.
Scorpion, killing it.
He's calling back a show I did 20 years ago. Awesome.
Yeah. Something like that.
Yeah, know. I think that's not a bad
idea.
That's
not a bad idea.
Fuck or, a burial pod. I don't even want that anymore.
And here's another thing. It's like we've been listening to Sword and Scale on the ride back and forth. Mm-hmm. And I was thinking about this. Like, if I died, if I was murdered, do you know what I want?
What?
I want a death where they can't ever solve it.
Oh, so I see.
A mystery?
All right, go ahead.
I want them to find my hand in
Hey,
Brazil.
Wait, hold on. You might be, telling people to...
No, they're not going to be able to do this.
Okay.
I want them to put my...
Challenge
find
people.
One of my hands in Brazil, but then a toe in Germany. Like, have a part of my body in every part of the world.
One part in every continent.
Right. They find my head in Alaska. You know what I mean? And my dick in the
Philippines.
Yeah. And then you would be like, how the fuck did this happen?
Yeah.
They just find it in a ditch. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's how I want to die.
Well, how does that even happen?
I know, that's why.
Well, how about you?
And then, like, they would wouldn't know, and I would be like a mystery.
I know, but you could just also die from natural causes, and I could just disperse your, you know, body parts all over the world. I can do that for you. Why would it have to be like a murder mystery?
That's true.
But it's cool.
That's true. What I about guess. This then? What if they found my dick in Mars? That's
badass. Oh, that's badass.
Yeah. How did I get up there?
Well, you were in there for 5 years already.
That's right. 5 years I was up there.
Yeah.
And I disappeared off the little space thing.
Yeah.
That'd be cool, huh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. What do we have time?
Perfect again.
Unhelpful advice and questions with Bobby and Khalyla.
We should do a better job at the unhelpful advice because we've been slacking.
I do 100% a good
thoughtful
job.
Advice.
I want to be thoughtful too. Go ahead, dude.
Single pussy or threesome? Dear what? Bobby, wait. Dear Bobby, I'm finally getting a place of my own, and I'm about to fulfill my childhood dream of getting pussy. ... A cat.
Aww.
I really would like a pair of kitties, but I'm hesitant as I would be a first-time owner. How much better is it owning multiple cats opposed to just one? Thanks, June from Gookland. P.S. Your bit as Tank in Matt TV still makes me piss my pants.
Okay, stop. Thank you. And I want to say this, and this is a fact, that you need two.
Reason.
You need to. Because when I was in San Jose Improv, the manager, Human, he's the manager of the club group, probably one of the best managers in comedy history.
Yeah,
I love him.
Nicest
guy in the world. He got one cat. The cat was lonely. He got two. Life was better.
Yeah.
My friend Billy Bonnell, two. He has two cats. Mm. You know what I mean? We have three, but the third one was an accident.
Ooh. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, Bojo was like a call out of nowhere, and you know what I mean, and from a fire station, we had to take it.
Yeah.
And we nursed it back to life, and that was a gift from God. My point, though, is that you need to. Because you leave, that fucking thing's going to be in the house alone.
Mm-hmm.
And you know what you can find is brothers or sisters or like a relation.
Yeah, they'll usually keep them in the same actual kennel, too, if they're in the same litter and stuff.
If you can go to a kennel and get, like, a brother and sister or two brothers, whatever, right?
Do it.
That's the way to do it. You know what I mean? And,
is that what you guys did?
But what happened was with Gunnar, we picked it up, and he had a brother, and they were in the same kennel, but some fucking asshole, you know what I mean?
Adopted the first one. Yeah.
So we could only get Gunnar. And then, you know what they did was, when we picked up Gunnar... They go, we're going to say goodbye. Gunnar's going to say goodbye to his brother. And his brother and Gunnar started crying like crazy.
Like screaming.
Screaming.
Because they were being separated.
They're being separated.
And they did it in front of us. We were like,
yeah, like,
do
that shit when we're not here. The goodbye.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Bitch. You know what I mean? But they didn't. You know what I mean? But to this person, it's very important to get two.
Get two cats.
Yeah.
Cool.
Cats are the best. They really are.
Cats are the
best. Changed my life.
You agree? Two cats?
Yeah, because when we first had Ming, Bobby can tell you, our first cat was alone for the first year of her life, and she was a lonely girl. Like, it took her forever to get out of her feral state because she didn't have any other pets around her. So when Bobby would go on the road, or if we were both gone, you know, she was miserable. alone. And then her personality completely changed, and she's complete 1,000 times more lovable now that she has the two boys with her.
I didn't know anything about cats, and I remember dating Khalyla, and I'm like, I'll take Ming to my house, see what happens. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And for 24 hours, I mean, I left water and food in here, but I just left it in here for 24 hours.
He didn't know.
In this room?
Yeah, in this room, wow. Locked it. And I walked in here like 24 hours later, and she's sitting on that table just shaking by herself.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Is that why she's so...
skittish.
Shy and skittish.
Well, she's
he traumaed your own cat.
No, we picked her up off the street. She's
when they
a feral
picked her
cat.
Up from the street, right? They left her that thing alone for
That's
3 months.
That's not true. What are you
Tolstoy.
Talking about?
With Tolstoy.
No, when we first got Ming was when Bobby and I first started dating, and I was in and out a lot. And my roommate was in and out a lot too, but she was with a dog. She was actually raised with a dog. But when she moved in with Bobby and I, she had no dog anymore. It was just her by herself. I am not a bad pet owner. How dare you?
Anyway, get two. Is there any other ones?
Yeah, one more. Hey guys, just listening to the earlier episode where you talk about your trip to the Philippines when Khalyla had a heart episode, and was wondering if Bobby would ever go back and visit the Philippines again after that experience. Was it traumatic?
Oh, man. Oh, yeah.
You would go back?
No.
Oh.
Yeah, of course I would. And we're going to go back next January when
hopefully we're not, what do you call it?
Bring George. Like, it'll be fun. You want to come?
Yeah.
And we'll tape stuff. Maybe we'll do a short film. We'll do something.
You don't think it would be traumatic for you at all?
No, I loved it there, man. I mean, if you saw the two videos that I posted in the first 2 days I was there.
The first day we were there.
I did a little karate thing by a pool. And then I did a dance thing in the lobby. It was so much fun. It was a great place.
It's impossible not to have fun in the Philippines. Yeah. The Philippines is just primed for a good time. It's
so fun, you know? Yeah. And the shit rivers, there were only a couple shit rivers I saw.
Just a couple.
You know what I mean? Just two really big shit rivers. Mm-hmm. Or just a river flowing with shit.
That was Khalyla's town.
You know what I mean?
Kiss.
Can I plug my gates?
Plug your dates? Yeah. Oh, shit.
Bobby Show.
Say something while I look for his dates, Gilbert.
Cool. Let's talk about some... let's have a... what do we call it? Baby Bellies, Tiger Belly Nation. First of all, here's... Thing number one. Guys, come up with a name for yourselves. It was Baby Bellies, but we don't know what it should be. So why don't you...
We can call them that.
We can, but
I'm not original enough to come out with anything like...
But let's have them help us. Let's have them help us. Yeah. So go on Twitter... Or you'll probably go on Twitter and just tweet us any like names this whole community should be called.
Right now we have baby bellies.
We're not taking George as a pink dick, so that's out of the question.
George as a pink dick was a hit in San Jose. People coming up to me after his shows. I mean, really like kind of shy girls, and they would pass by me and they would just whisper, "George is a pink dick," and then walk away. And then they would look at me from afar like, I wonder if she heard me.
How creepy is that?
And then I would be like, wait, what'd you say? And then they would be like, George has a pink dick? And I'm like, yeah, he does.
So picture, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, Bobby was, he took pictures. So we went to dinner with some of the other guys that listened to the podcast, like Arthur and a bunch of them. And it was a good time. It was a really good time. Okay, guys. Tour dates for Bobby. Bobby is going to be at the Ontario Improv March 18th through the 20th. March 7th through the 9th, he is going to be doing shows with Harlan Williams, Polly Shore, Tom Green. It's called The Comedy Party, and it's one is in April 7th, Joliet, Illinois. The next is in Rockford, Illinois, and April 9th is in, is it called Dubuque, Iowa?
Dubuque, I think. Right?
Is it Dubuque? Dubuque. Yeah. April 21st to the 23rd, he is doing shows in Texas at Hyenas Comedy Nightclub. First night will be in Plano, Texas. Second will be in Fort Worth. And the third night will be in Dallas, Texas. So he's just doing one show per city. Mm-hmm. And May 6th through 7th, he is going to be at the Gotham Comedy Club in New York. That should be a fun one. May 12th through the 14th, Stand Up Live in Phoenix, Arizona. And June 16th through the 18th, he is going to be in Raleigh, North Carolina at Good Nights Comedy Club.
Are you going to New York?
I think so. I want to. I've
never been to New York.
You should come with.
I think I will.
We should all go.
I think we should do a road trip.
You've never been to New York, Gilbert.
Can you smile? For sure smile. You angry person.
Yes, okay, guys. I think we should address this.
Okay, guys. State of Union address. Go ahead.
About my smiling?
Your smile first.
Oh, I think that... Okay, so here's okay, my thing with it. And you guys obviously know how anxious I always am.
First
I'm
of all,
sweating.
Why is this being prompted? Why are we
this
prompting
this? This is being prompted because I think that after... watching myself on video. I mean, I've always been fine doing these audio podcasts, no problem, right? Mm-hmm. But I think that because I'm so inexperienced and I'm so unaware of what I look like on camera, I look at myself, I'm like, wow, I look like a raging, angry bitch. And I do. So Gilbert and George are helping me becoming more smiley.
Well, okay. I'll give you a scenario.
It's just not my natural state of being is like I'm always thinking, so I always have this, like, you know, I have a bitch face.
Yeah, you're a bitch
and
face.
I always do this, yeah. Right, but I'm smiling on the inside. I'm actually quite happy when I have thoughts and I want to convey thoughts to Bobby, or if I get like passionate about a conversation, I always look angry, so I'm trying to soften that a little bit.
She's not mad, she's just thinking.
Is this good?
Yeah, it looks terrifying, but yes, that's good. It's much better.
Okay, thank you. I'm trying. I'm trying.
Thank you
guys.
So much. So speaking of that, let's segue to, we have vlogs now.
Oh, that's right, guys. We just put up our first vlog on our Tiger Belly channel, and it's a quick short one of Bobby and I going cat food shopping. Mm-hmm. We're going to be uploading those. We're going to try for every Monday from here on out. And it's going to be, you know, just silly little outings of...
Day in the life.
Yeah, basically. Some weeks it's going to be just Bobby and I. Other weeks it's going to be the four of us together on our little misadventures as Tiger Belly. So make sure you subscribe and make sure, you know, you write in the comment section and let us know what you want to see. Mm-hmm. Also, we've already set up a PO box today, finally.
Yeah,
and do we want to put that
let's
up?
Let's hold it up and read it out loud for the only audio listeners.
So anything you guys want to send us, any art, any, basically anything you want to send us, just hopefully nothing, you know, too creepy and no explosives would be nice.
Yeah. So while we're getting that, let me just explain, if you're also wondering, what are they holding up? We're holding up the PO box address because of the YouTube channel. So if you're listening to this right now, let me just break down the little schedule. Mondays, we have vlogs on the YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/tigerbelly. Then on Wednesday, releases the audio podcast, and you can get that on iTunes, Stitcher, or allthingscomedy.com. And then on Friday morning on the YouTube channel again, comes out the video of the podcast.
So the full-length video podcast on Friday. So that's Monday vlogs, Wednesday audio podcast on iTunes, and Friday... full-length video vlog on our YouTube channel. So make sure you guys subscribe and
check that out. Yeah,
check it out. And also you can find me on Instagram at Calamity K, on Twitter at Calamity K as well. You can
find Tiger Belly
at Tiger Belly on Instagram, at The Tiger Belly on Twitter, and email us all your questions for unhelpful advice or just any questions in general to thetigerbelly@gmail.com.
And make sure you also follow us on Periscope, because we now are periscoping.
Or we try.
We try before podcast, after podcast. You guys can hang out with us then.
Yes. And merch is coming.
Merch is coming.
We promise.
And the reason why it's taking a little longer is because we're trying to give you guys a good quality product. We're not just trying to go to fucking Walmart and just, you know, take a Sharpie and write Tiger Belly on it. What if it is?
What if it's so shitty?
No,
yes, guys. We're taking our time with it. We've taken the time with...
Surprise!
Oh, whoa!
George is wearing a Tiger Belly. That's not our actual Tiger Belly shirt.
That's not. Yeah, that's not.
This is what happens if you do take a Sharpie.
Is that with a stencil?
George took a shirt, did a stencil, and spray painted it.
George, I like the deep V. I might accidentally dream of you eating my butt again tonight.
He's freaking out. Look at him. But guys, you know what? George brought up a good point. What a great segue. While our shirts are getting ready, feel free to make your own Tiger Belly.
Anything.
Anything. Wear it. Take a picture of it, and we'll repost it on Twitter and Instagram. And put any pictures you take with Bobby and Khalyla at the shows, put those up on Twitter.
Unless I don't look good and try to add a filter to my face. Thank you.
Definitely, yeah. What's that other thing that squishes it down and make it skinnier?
Curves?
What is it called?
Auto-tune?
Auto-tune?
Oh, no, I'm sorry. Facetune.
Facetune.
I think that's what you do to, like, smoosh, like, yeah, your face and make it, like, contour and stuff. And look at, I mean, look at the width of this face, George.
Yeah.
It needs some contouring. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and we will see you next week. Ciao.
Bye. Visit our website at Gilbits on Instagram. Bye. Kaya kapag nandun lumba, sukulok mo na iye. Sukutugan ko mo, pagkaki. Sukumula ka o na pagkamiulubi. Buro kaya kapag nandun lumba, sukulok mo na iye. Sukulokin mo kisa laman ng feet. Ang buko gani ay makabaluli.
No, are it's Mexican, hearty.
But Mexican.
It's Mexican because I'll tell you why. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
How many Canadians sneak over to the United States over the border?
I'm not sure.
Not a lot.
Not a lot. Yeah.
How many Mexicans? A lot.
Everyone.
Everyone.
Every single
them.
One.
They
has
all
done
want
it
to come here, and they do it.
Also,
you know why? Because of heart, resilience, right? And they're a tough group of people. And fuck, you don't fuck with Mexicans, man. You know what I mean? And Nick Diaz
but
was getting.
Also, Canada has more liberties and they have universal health care. So why would they want to hop over as much as the Mexicans?
Because they have a lot of creepy white people up there.
That's true.
You know what I mean? They have serial killers up
like
there.
Like Georgie? Georgie, you're not creepy. You know, you're not creepy.
I mean, George. I know Ed Gein is from Wisconsin, but dude, you know what I mean? I love Canada. Canada's the best.
I want to talk more about this yeah. Connor thing. Yeah. So we were watching it at the improv, and it's a pity we didn't get a video of our reactions. I mean, I look at this right here. I don't know if you can see it, but that is rug burn because I literally did it.
She blew everyone in the room. I mean,
wait. So Connor
gets tapped out and she just starts pulling out dick instead of sucking. I'm like,
so what are you
crying,
doing?
Baby, what are you doing?
I was like, suck crying. I was blowing and tears were going down. Yeah, I had given up
no,
on
No, she
life.
Did a slide on her knees.
Because I was in disbelief. I mean, not so much like shock or disbelief that Nate couldn't pull it off. Because I was telling Bobby and I was telling everyone, if this goes past the second round, it could get interesting. I just didn't know it would happen that quickly and that soon. So I did a fucking knee slide on carpet, and I Human, the manager of the club, was standing right there, and I literally grabbed like hit this part of his suit. Yes. And I got on my knees and I was like, why?
Yeah.
I couldn't believe it.
Did you cry?
Didn't cry. I love Nate. I honestly yeah. respect Nate. I love that he brings his fan base, and I think that he's underrated, underpaid, one of the most appreciated fighters in the UFC, and you know, I'm glad that he's finally getting his payday, because that motherfucker has been paying his dues for.
I literally ran into a different room and I fucking threw a table.
Like, actually, it wasn't a different room. It was the same room. You flip a chair and a table.
No, in the other room. Oh, I ran into the other room where there was no one there.
You went to an empty room.
An empty room, an office, and I pulled a table. I flipped a table, and nobody watched me do it. I just did it because it was just so stunning to me.
I want to know, because Gilbert is the ultimate McGregor fan. I mean, you are.
I don't hate Nate Diaz, but Connor.
Connor is your boy.
He's my boy.
He is. So what was it like? What did you feel in your heart?
I don't know. I would need it to be like replayed again.
Okay, let me do a rear naked.
Oh, so like Bobby's
Nate
real
Diaz.
Quick.
Bobby's, yeah, I'm Nate, and this is Connor, and
you don't have to do a rear naked.
I'm not going to do a real one
no,
on
he
you.
Could, if he can't visualize what it was like seeing it, then he's a fucking retard.
Let me just do a quick one.
What, you just want to put me in a rear naked show? That's fine. But
he's like, well, just so you guys know, this was kind of a bit, but all right.
Okay.
I'm at the bar. I'm at Big Wang's.
I do some ground and pound. Okay. And
I'm like, oh fuck, Connor, get out, Connor.
Hold on, Bobby.
Okay. Do what Connor does, Bobby. Connor. Connor. I didn't cry, but shit, my heart dropped. My heart did drop.
No.
Now we did all that for that. Just,
yeah,
let,
I wanted
just
to
FYI.
Know.
FYI?
Yeah, yeah.
She wanted to choke you.
We did all that for that.
Okay. Didn't even do a proper
and can I say something? I want to say that I am 100% now a Conor McGregor fan.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know who
I listen. listen for a second. Fuck. Okay. Didn't like him before. I was being sold on him a little bit through the years. I mean, throughout the year. But he was so humble. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
And he took it such like a man, mm-hmm. right? He's very analytical about it, you know, about why he lost. Mm-hmm. But he gave props to Nate Diaz. Mm-hmm. And what Jose Aldo.
Who's Jose?
Jose Aldo Instagrammed it or Twittered.
Tweeted
the pussy
was so disrespectful
that he was
that I now am on. You're strange. Just
you're
making up
strange
shit.
Strange man.
Because they were oppressed. Okay.
No, I'm just saying they've had a hard history.
And that's what makes him a champion.
No, that's not what I'm saying at all. Okay. Wow. If you could just attach some ears to the side of your face, that would be really nice.
Ooh. What are you getting all like aggressive for? I was just
fighting.
Smile, Khalyla. Khalyla, smile.
Get through it.
Smile for the camera.
Yeah, Khalyla's under
it.
The weather
what,
a little bit.
One more thing about that press conference. Did you guys see how he grabbed Holly Holm's shoulder?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. That was sweet.
That was, so that was sweet. Endearing.
Damn.
But can I just say about Holly Holm?
Yeah.
Come on.
What do you mean?
Wait. No, come on. Let's be real. And if I was just, if I ran into her, the only thing I would say to her is, come on.
Bob, is that Bobby Lee from Matt TV?
yeah. I'll say, come on. Because it's seriously, you can't.
Stop it.
No, fuck, no.
Uh-oh,
you're the champion, all mm-hmm. right? And you're winning the fight. And mm-hmm. there's a minute left, right? And there's a little bit of a pocket where Miesha Tate ran in. She swarmed in for the takedown.
A weak takedown,
she
too.
Didn't even she kind of snuck around the back.
What do you call that?
And Holly could have stood up. I just felt like she could have stood up, but she didn't. And all that other stuff was moot and too late, and you lost, and you may never get the belt back. So I'm just saying, come on,
Holly.
Yeah, you fucked up.
But you're a great athlete.
Yeah, I don't think that Connor fucked up. I think Connor miscalculated that he was fighting a Mexican zombie that has no feelings in his face because he hit him 1,000 times with his left hand.
That was a crazy.
And
left.
There was moments in there where Connor in his head said, "Fuck, I usually hit guys with these punches, like." Jose Aldo once, mm-hmm. right? And he knocked down.
13 seconds.
But this fucking Mexican zombie
spirit.
Just kept going. No, it's not spirit. It's just deadened nerves
and
in his
I
face.
I think also the advantage that Nate Diaz has is that with Connor and all his other opponents, Connor can employ psychological warfare onto them. He can get in their heads. He can, you know, get them to feel emotional. That's just not something you can do with any of the Diaz brothers. They're masters of not giving a fuck. They're masters of deflecting any type of psychological warfare.
And they're dum-dums, though. Let's be real.
They're not dum-dums.
I don't give a fuck.
They're like Manny Pacquiao. It's simpleton.
You know what I mean? Just fuck it.
I think that they're eccentric.
That's eccentric?
Ooh. Yeah, I think that they've had, you know...
I feel like we're eccentric.
They're yeah. No. I think that there is... That's a perfect word for him. They're often sometimes like... You know,
they're smart then. You think they're smart?
I don't. I can't say that they're not. I think that people have different type of intelligence. Maybe they're not great speakers. They're not great orators. They're not great, you know, in terms of maybe like, you know,
what
really
is this?
Explaining how
the
they
money
feel.
Channel.
But he does have some good one-liners.
Channel.
What did he
That's
say?
That's what he said. Yeah, yeah.
He said Connor was playing touch butt in the park.
Yeah.
That was
touch
funny.
Butt with that goofy ponytail guy, man. Fuck you.
With Ido Portal, the movement.
Code. Yeah.
Yeah.
Touch butt. That's funny.
No, I like the brothers. I think that they're, you know, a great example of some just the hardworking dudes from Stockton.
Fun,
and
right?
I love
Let's
them.
Not talk about fucking. I mean, people are bored if they don't know about the UFC, and I feel bad, kind of guilty about it, you know.
Okay. Yeah.
But can I say something magical that happened on the way? We drove to San Jose, mm-hmm. and we stopped at a gas station. Okay, and I got some Red Bull. You know, I got some nuts. You know, I love getting nuts over there.
Yeah.
Like not, you know.
Yeah.
Like getting like packaged nuts.
Yeah.
We were in
Santanella. I was smoking a cigarette off the side, and we're in Santanella.
Santanella is like
Santanella,
but fucking nowhere. There's
nowhere.
Just gas stations and
like Bakersfield
farms
or worse.
Bakersfield is a beautiful place. Shut the fuck up.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. It's a beautiful place, and thank you for the money. 2 weeks ago, that was an amazing payday. But I was smoking, and all of a sudden I see one cat, a little cat, and he was scared, mm-hmm. a little black one. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And he was like, meow, meow. And he kind of ran away.
Four in the morning.
I go, fuck, there's a cat, right?
Yeah.
I love cats, you know that. And then all of a sudden you looked out in the field, and like it's like they just started coming out of this brush. There was like these, I know it's not wheat, but they look like wheat. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's not wheat.
I don't think they were growing anything. It was like basically flatland.
It's wheat.
And weeds.
Okay.
It looked like wheat.
Weeds.
Okay, there's something growing. Yeah.
Something
there's
growing.
A fucking plant.
The, the argument of wheat or no
shrubbery.
Wheat.
Shrubbery. 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 Yeah, that's a better word.
Shrubbery.
Yeah.
Shrubbery. And there was a bunch of them that came out of there. It was a whole beautiful land of cats.
It was just this
field.
Big prairie of just kittens and cats.
It was
like,
and
how
I
many
it,
roughly? Like,
I saw about 20 maybe in the beginning.
But in like a small area, and they were just running around free. So we wanted to go back there and capture. Yeah.
I mean, they weren't even feral, really. They were
you know feral.
I mean? Well, I mean, they said meow to me. They didn't go, you know what I mean?
Oh, they spoke to you?
What?
They spoke to you?
Well, then we go meow like that. That's hi. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
They didn't do a Nate Diaz. You know what I mean? And then they went meow like Connor. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But I want to go back there. And my opener, Billy Bonnell, and I one day we're going to make money.
Yeah.
And we're going to open up a cat sanctuary.
I think that's our dream come true. Remember when the lottery, that big lottery draw a few weeks ago, where that person, where like the jackpot was like $1 billion mm-hmm. or some shit like that? Bobby and I were the night before, because we bought a few tickets, we were like, what are we going to do with this money? And all we could think about and all we could conjure up as a plan was to just build a cat sanctuary.
Yeah.
To just buy a shit ton of land and just, you know, spay and neuter cats and then keep them if they don't have any homes.
I mean, we're not going to grab everyone. There's an interview process. Only the good ones and the cute ones.
What are these? So what are some of the things you have to qualify?
Well, the
only
color.
Pretty cats then?
Ooh, the color.
Yeah.
What colors are exempted?
What color?
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
I have a cat. I have a couple cats. I wanted to know, I have a black cat. I have a white cat. And I have a yellow cat.
What does a black cat look like?
Like a Donald Glover.
Oh, it's a Donald Glover cat.
Yeah, it has the
There's
same...
no white spots or nothing?
No, it's a Donald Glover cat.
Yeah, nah.
What do you mean, nah? Sir, this is a cat. You said it's a cat sanctuary.
I said, nah.
Okay, what about my white cat?
Yes.
What about my yellow cat?
Yes.
But my black cat?
Nah.
Oh, okay, I guess I'll go to Petco.
Go to Petco.
Interesting, okay.
Because of bad luck. It has nothing to do with the race. There's no race in terms of cats.
I didn't even bring up race.
I'm just telling you that right now. The color of it has nothing to do with race. I'm just going to say that. Okay. It has to do with, like, you know, superstitions.
Okay.
Right? So if a black cat, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? If there was a horde of black cats, they wouldn't come into my sanctuary.
What
All black cats.
Well, if there's spots of white, then they're like Obama.
So race is involved?
Race has nothing to do with it.
Oh, okay.
But to me, they're like, you know, they're not as bad luck because there's some white in it. You know
okay,
what I mean?
Okay, what about what about like a one-eyed white cat or
nope.
a three-legged yellow cat?
Nope.
But it looks
so
at you.
So no.
I don't give a fuck.
No injured.
Three legs.
Meow.
Nope.
Bobby.
Well, it wouldn't. The second sound wouldn't come out.
If it okay,
a second sound would not come out.
A three-legged cat. Yeah. It actually says Bobby, and it's a sign from God. A cat actually says your name, but it has three legs.
Well, then yeah, of course.
There we go.
But that would never happen, Gilbert. Because if it said Bobby, then I'm going to be like, oh shit, I'm going to make a lot of money because now I have a circus freak show.
Okay, true.
Right, and I would charge money, $50 a head, and it can talk. And, you know what I mean? I'll be killing it. All right, but that doesn't happen.
Yeah.
All right. So let's say you're a three-legged cat.
Yeah.
And you're a guy.
Yeah.
Sell it to me.
Hey, I have a three-legged cat.
Cool. Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
Does it say circus on my fucking sanctuary?
Hey man, it's my cat.
I'm asking you a question. Do you
know? No, it's my cat.
Well then go.
Your wife has been very quiet this whole time.
What? She's a jungle Asian.
I'm also part of the circus.
The jungle Asian, she's in the circus.
Is that the lady with three boobs?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No, only you know what I mean, cats that aren't fully black and that have all four legs and eyes and stuff. And I'm telling you right now, it has nothing to do with race, and that's fucking ridiculous.
Or disabilities.
It has to do with disabilities.
Oh, it has to do with disabilities, though.
Yeah, because let me ask you a question.
Okay.
Welcome to Tiger Belly. My name is Bobby Lee, and I'm with Khalyla and Gilbert and Pink Dick George. And man, I want to say I'm very full of gratitude and love in my heart. Man, I just want to be, I'm appreciative of my life, man. Like, I was just in San Jose playing at the improv there, and a lot of Tiger Belly fans came out, and a lot of people said George has a pink dick. Probably about 80 people. I'm not even fucking
kidding. Really?
Yeah, I swear to God. In line, people would just whisper, George has a pink dick. And it really made me feel good.
Our server, when we first got there Friday night, the guy who works at the improv who serves the food, he comes in with the drinks, like some fried shrimp, and he was like, George is a pink dick. Yeah, and we're like, whoa, shit.
It's great. And that's nice. Wanted to say thank you, George, for, you know, I met you at Maker, and I've always found you as a really nice person. And I can tell that you really work hard and you're into things, and I really appreciate it. Gilbert, I just want to say that you're just a fucking ball of fresh energy, dude.
Whoa,
yeah,
man.
Dude, fresh energy. Yo, I'm not dumb, fucker.
All right, dog. All right, dog.
You're full of fresh energy, dude, and a nimble spirit, dude, like you bend.
Okay,
hold on. Your soul. I just want to say also is that when I look at your face, it brightens my day, bro. Like, you have a really good face.
Yeah, thanks, man.
And your intentions are good and pure, man. And your foundation is strong, bro.
My foundation?
Yeah.
Shit.
What about me?
Okay, well,
No. Khalyla already knows. Now look at me.
Let me say this. When I walk in, I'm like, my day kind of sucks. I see that yellow hat. I'm like, is that Bobby?
Yeah, it's nothing to do with my.
I'm not there. I'm not there yet. I'm not there yet. And I see your face. It usually does this. Here's the camera. Okay, if the camera's me, this is Bobby. Hey, what's up, bro? And I just go, oh, I get so warm inside. I really do.
That's it?
I get warm.
You didn't, I don't like your adjectives for Bobby. You could have done a better job.
No, I guess not.
Warm?
He called you nimble. I feel like you prepared a fucking paragraph for me. I feel bad now.
I know. I called you a nimble spirit.
You said I had a great foundation?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Where I build a house on. But you know what?
Can I just say you're a good
now
guy?
Now I just realized
what?
That house is built on sand now, and it's not a good foundation. And you fuck you.
I'm not good with words.
I know, man.
I'm sorry.
That wasn't good. George, thanks for being here, man. Go fuck yourself. Now, let me say something. And of course, I have the beautiful and lovely and charismatic Khalyla, my girlfriend. My blessings are deep with her, man. You know what I mean?
Let's hold hands. I don't want to hold hands right now. Come on. Like lovers, babe.
Our blessings are deep.
Babe, like lovers,
and,
come on.
Babe. What I want to say
don't
is
don't leave
is
me
that,
hanging, babe.
What I want to say is that. What I want to say is that this weekend, not only were my shows very good at the San Jose Improv, thank you, San Jose, but also we were able to see probably one of the best nights of UFC I've ever seen in my fucking life.
Crazy night.
Misha Tate won, and she was losing the whole fight, I thought.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I thought she was losing the whole fight, clearly. The second round was hers, probably.
Second round, yeah.
But all the other rounds were all Holly. Yep. And at the last minute, she puts Holly in a rear naked chokehold, and it was fucking amazing.
That's the beauty about Misha Tate. She's, in several of her fights, she'll come from behind, and she'll come from winning, from losing a few couple rounds, and she's a finisher. She's a tough bitch, man. She's an ox. I mean, you saw her on top of Holly. Holly couldn't shake her off often.
That was crazy.
And then the fight after that, which was almost life-altering. Conor McGregor gets choked out, rear naked choke by Nick Diaz. And
Nate Diaz.
Nathan.
They're brothers. Nick,
I know,
I was close.
But Nick is 185. You
I know.
They're the same. They're Mexican.
Can I just say something? Exactly.
Yeah. Well,
that's
from
what
the
I
209.
Say. You can't fuck with Mexican spirit.
Wow.
You can't fuck with that Stockton spirit. Those
Conor McGregor side for life.
But it was a little bit sus to me because the tweet was in perfect English. So, I mean,
I feel
sure
like he had a marketing person.
It was a marketing person who did that. They want the fight. UFC. They want the million-dollar fight. Every guy wants it. He's going to stir the pot as much as he can to get that UFC 200 fight. Yeah. Is it the 200?
And people listening, probably half of you people don't even care about the UFC. I apologize for, you know what I mean? But it was such a dramatic,
very dramatic,
you know what I mean, moment, you know, in UFC history that I thought that it was something that we needed to share.
And,
okay?
And here's why McGregor to me is, I think John Jones is one of the most talented fighters I have ever seen. But I remember starting to kind of, my feelings for John Jones started to fade. Because I remember years ago when he was supposed to fight Dan Henderson. And maybe like 2 weeks prior, Dan Henderson pulled out from injury. Mm-hmm. And so Chael Sonnen stepped in and he was like, look, I'll fly in tonight. I'll fight him tonight. And John Jones was like, nah. I'm not going to defend my title against a guy who on short notice with a new guy. And that twice in the last 9 months, Conor McGregor not only defended on short notice, but he went 2 weight classes up.
Yeah.
I mean, you can dislike the guy for everything, for you know, being arrogant, for being, you know, some people think he's a little like braggadocious, but that motherfucker has done so much. And people throw in the whole race thing. Like they say, oh, you know, because he's a white man and they've really, this organization has pushed him because he's a white man. But I honestly think that there might be some truth behind that, but I honestly think there is no better person or ambassador for the sport that can speak like Connor. And Ireland's like an oppressed nation, you know?
Yeah.
So I don't think that he quite applies as like the typical white man.
I don't even know if that.
What?
What does that mean?
No, because some people are like, well, what about, okay, let me ask you this.
Yeah.
They're like, well, how come the UFC, given that Nate Diaz and Nick Diaz have been around forever since they were like 17 years old, how come they've only ever gotten paid $40,000 per fight, even though they do have a huge fan base?
No, I'm talking about the oppression thing about the Ireland. What does that mean?
Oh, what do you mean?
What's the history?
Bobby,
what does that have anything to do with it?
I'm taking the words out of your mouth.
Well, I never said that.
Oh God! What?
When did I say that?
Oh God!
Oh God! What?
This is where I'm gonna expose you in 2 seconds.
Expose! Uh-oh. Expose Uh-oh. Away! Expose Uh-oh. Away! I have no idea what you mean by that.
Okay. Yeah, you want to be exposed?
Yeah, I'll expose me.
You want to be exposed?
Yeah, I love big exposure.
Okay.
I hate being indoors. I want to be exposed.
Okay. Oftentimes in this podcast.
Uh-oh.
I will take what you've said. Okay. And make it my own.
Uh-huh.
Because it's a little bit too inflammatory.
Being a thief, but anyway.
No, it's a little bit too inflammatory for you to say.
Oh shit, yeah.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
I
know.
Okay. Oh, see? You want me to expose you or not?
Well, don't expose what I think you're going to expose. Expose the part that when in terms of the Ireland thing, expose that.
Oh, selective exposing, yeah.
Well, you can't expose shit that like I said to her on the side that's like completely like private.
No, not private. You know, it's not that private. I could expose you right now.
With who?
Oh, you know. I already know.
D?
Mm-hmm.
No. What does that have anything to do with the other thing I just said, bitch? One has nothing to do with the other. I can expose you too, bitch.
Expose me.
You want to expose each other?
Let's expose each other. Come on.
Exposure with Bobby and Khalyla.
I'm not exposing nothing, okay? So anyway.
What I'm saying is, everything that I'm saying right now is from a conversation that you and I have had over the weekend about the fight.
Okay.
In terms of you know.
I never said anything about the Ireland being
oppressed. That's not
oppressed,
true.
But.
That's not true. Are you serious?
Mm-hmm. With his smile is so deceiving.
Strange.
Jesus, you're strange,
man.